Hello everyone, welcome to part one of hopefully a new series of mine. So, we'll be playing Forza Horizon 4 with a brand new Hot Wheels DLC, which has been long awaited and is insanely cool. So what we'll be doing is we'll kind of be going, only sounds weird, going for a walkthrough of Forza. So, but we're not going to play it as a racing game, so we're going to start off in the Hot Wheels truck because I want to drive it, I want a reason to drive it. I'm going to start off in the Hot Wheels truck, make deliveries, get money. Our starter car is a Toyota GT86 and this truck. We want to upgrade the GT86 to do races and all that good stuff. But first of all, we need to take our lovely truck. And if I can turn it up so you can hear the stupid V8 in it. So this will be what we are using to transport cargo. Now, obviously, oh hello, you're in a box one. So obviously we can't actually carry cargo, we're just gonna hope. But we're gonna have it in the, because we've got a V8 in the back here, we are going to be getting rid of that V8, putting in a normal diesel, and we are going to be putting a actual curtain side trailer on the back. So the company is called Hauling Trucks, and that company is works as a pub here. So, freeze frame, don't mind that. So, if we pull in here, nope, I missed the wrong turning. I've stolen it. So, oh yeah, why is this truck not going to pause? Right, so, we want to go into the cargo truck entrance into here, and then we want to get it into reverse, and we will now load up the truck, and I will come back to you when we load up the truck. Okay, so I left the camera in the truck, but we have loaded it all up now. We have got a load of cargo in the back. Apparently we are transporting lots of bags of, lots of boxes of drinks. So we're going to be delivering them to a village called Ambleside, I think. So, get some beans. So, we need to, actually, our GPS isn't set. It was going off memory, but it's not going to work. But so we get a line so we can quickly change it. So we want to be going right to here, in Ambleside. We want to be going down here. That is where we're going. So while we're there, so while we're on the way there, I can say some stuff. So like, yeah, so the reason I haven't been uploading very much is just because of it sick. But yeah, I'm back to uploading properly now. And Sandy Bay hasn't gone that well. I've been trying to record episodes, but it isn't working properly, it's way too glitchy and nothing's really working. So I thought to start a new series on Forza. Oh, did you just hit him? Nope. Right, so we're starting at night. We've got 5 miles to go. We're going through Broadway. We're going to go around the turning into the festival, but not into it. We're on a long road. Minnie, can I go past you? And then on a main road, all the way. All the way up to Ambleside, and then that's where we will deliver our cargo. So, as you can see, going a bit fast. And some cargo will be vehicles, and some vehicles we may have to be delivering by actually driving it ourselves. So, hopefully, we will be able to do that sometime. So, yeah. Ah, there is our rival company, the normal trucks, which aren't as good as us, obviously. Speed camera, so I'll put into first, go slowly, don't mind me. But yeah, this is the new Hot Wheels DLC, and it's worth the wait, it's so cool. But next thing I want is that truck over there. If that was in the game, that would be amazing. So, if I've met would let us pass. Yeah, he let us pass. Come in, but come in, mate. Put it in third gear and we're coming nice and peacefully around this village. We're 3 miles away. Nearly here. Hopefully we can do quite a few deliveries in this video and even hopefully some upgrades to the GT86. And hopefully we'll be able to upgrade to current circles or Bugattis, or even better, R34s or R33s. Oh, slip that. As my clutch is very delayed, I'm not really sure why. Right. I've got a Volkswagen Boar here. It does bore you when you're behind me. A little speedy bike. I'm surprised I can actually go around this corner. It's a massive truck. We are very, very, very close to our destination. So we shall simply just be around here. Now, this company ships globally, but sadly, this truck does not go to locations it can go, but it can go to Colorado. It also ships to Italy, and it also ships to Australia. It's a massive coincidence that that's where Forza Horizon 3, Forza Horizon 2, Forza Horizon 1 was set. I know, massive coincidence. But yeah, we can go there. But I thought we should probably do it. Yes, thank you, Anna. Probably do it best, first of all, in our homeland, where all of our stuff is, and where our proper truck is. Where we know how to get the grips of it. Along a peaceful village. Now, I don't really know where the location is, but I think I do know it is, or it should be, just along this road. It has a big parking, jeez. It has a big parking garage, if I'm not mistaken. That is a good gear. Should see it. Ah, here it is. Have I missed the entrance? No. Right, enter it in. Now, where do we park our deliveries?
When it is safe to do so.
Thank you, Anna. Right. Oh, no. Jeez. Okay, well, I shouldn't be driving along here. Where do you want deliveries? I don't know what that was. This truck is really wide, isn't it? Okay, yeah, just leave it here, they said. Right, I shall now see you in a second. Right, okay, so again, camera's licking the truck, but we're back. Now, we're going to go back to just where we came from, and this is a really good news. Our next cargo trip, which we will be doing, will be transporting an actual car.
Turn left.
So yeah, exciting. It is, this is really cool. It is German.
Turn left.
It is made by a brand called Porsche. So it's German, okay. And it has around 1,000 horsepower. Has a V8 hybrid. And you think of what car it is. But basically, we have to go to an undisclosed location in this village to do that. Now, I know it will look like a small house, but underneath it, here it is. And I'll show you all the cars they have that we can ship out in it. So if we look, these are all the cars can ship out. So, we want to go. Because these are all the cars that people haven't probably paid for. And these are all the cars, and we're the only person that can properly do it in the UK. So here we are. Here is the car we are delivering. Now we want to be incredibly careful with it, because we do not want to damage it. And we shall be doing it with manual and clutch. Don't ask me why. But we'll be... So we're going. This is a big, big opportunity. I won't send it fast at all. Oh wait, there's a problem with the car. Wait, let me just go in to the menu. So basically, this is planted in the car. So this is basically, you are now seeing the centre console. So if we look, and we can change all the parts of the car here. So I want to put it into the manual mode, because this is in the self dash. And I want to make it in comfort mode, because we're going to be going all the way up to Edinburgh. So I'm going to be driving completely normal. With a speed, but not too much. I'm going to be careful not to wake up any neighbours here on our side. Yep, don't mind me. Probably put in a high gear. Speed cameras. Right. Yeah. It's a long way, but I do know the way and I don't need GPS. So we're going to go this way, I think. Now obviously we shouldn't be driving it this fast, but it's a customer car, and basically they did say make sure you just get it through all the gears and check the brakes on the way there to make sure the customer's car is working in perfect condition. So we shall do that. Oh, there's a small car going on here. Very big change of pace from the International, which is the truck now. The lovely green upholstery is just insane. Now, I've mounted the camera on the back of it so you can see this can get its full attention. And now be backing off the throttle. Jeez, we've proven what this thing can do. So warmed up, and we should go any faster, but we can. Didn't see that car. Big cameras. Okay, yeah, but anyway, we're around the transit. That's on here on the brakes. Stop behind me. So all the other series we have started, there was quite a problem because my Xbox, thankfully, it went bye-bye, and made me do a factory reset. Everything falls and save, but mean everything didn't save, only this did. So the Toyota team hasn't saved, but we can always start that completely again for a new fresh start. But at the moment, we're only going to be doing Forza and this big, precious delivery. Right? As fast as you can, think you can get. With an 80, I'm going to go on the brakes here. The fourth wheel and it's working very well there. Okay, why is the truck there? Hello there. I think this person is also doing some import work in his Lamborghini Huracan. Oh, Daphne. So now we're going on the motorway where I definitely shouldn't test the top speed of the Porsche, but I will. So here we go. Theoretically, it should go, and I bet, should go 217 miles an hour. But I think that we can hit 220. So here we go. You can see our boost charging on the left dial. Come on, come on, come on, fast as we can. 90, geez, 200. Okay, we're fine. That was just an optical illusion because that car just de-swarmed. I don't know what happened. I didn't hit a standard of weights because it was just, I don't know, it just hit straight away. But anyway, we'll be driving it full pace. Come on. Try and hit 220. Come on. 200. It is still stretching. It will go as fast as that. Okay, we're going to stop here. This wheel will just go off. Back on acceleration. Keep the boost coming up. Let up. Come on, back on the acceleration. Come on, come on. Hit 200. Okay. 5, 6, 10, 15, 17, we've hit it. 18, 19, 20, we've hit 220 miles an hour. Okay, that's impossible to hit, but we did actually hit 220, so yeah. Now we are sadly at an end of this car, but hopefully one day we'll be able to own it. So we are now arriving at Edinburgh, very close to a truck. Well, I bet what time is it at the moment? No, I'll turn to his. I'm in the wrong way. And basically, we are just going to Edinburgh Castle. It's a very special place. We probably shouldn't have been switching as fast as we can. So that van just tried to pull up. One last send on it. Okay. Yes. Come on. Hurry up. Yeah. Oh, that's a spin. Yeah, speaking of top there. And we have bit sensibly now. Listen to this thing. Sounds amazing. One more blast. Right, now we have delivered it. So now, time to go back into our imports, what we can import, and what we're going to get brought to us will be our beautiful, lovely, beautiful, lovely pickup truck. So what we own is this International Harvester, a Toyota GT86 and a Chevrolet Louvre. That is what we own. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get into the Chevrolet Louvre, because what we're going to do, we're going to go down to a place called the Red Cup, down the road in Edinburgh. I can't remember what it is, but it's called a Larking Red Cup, and it's only a very small parcel. We're going to be doing small parcels, and we can put them in the back next to the V8. Yep, it can warm. So we're going to be, this is going to be, so this and the, where is it, Larking Red Cup? It's along here. Oh, here it is. In here. Yep, here it is. The Larking Red Cup. So, spread it with parcels and let's go and deliver. Ooh. So, we're going to, so our, where's the 599? So, our first destination is the house just next to our. Just next to the main road, so we need to get out of Edinburgh. And this mini doesn't stop slowing anything. But a second, let's go. This is my project plan. Yep, thank you, person, for coming in the recording. So the choices you said six is our project car, but this car is a car I built at the auction house. So basically, this is a car that I bought the stock version of this off the auction house, and I built it up to be perfect. And I put the beer in the back, and I made all the fenders and stuff like that. And this is what it is now. Whose fault was that? Because I was braking before any. Are you still trying to hit me? Are you alright? Okay. Well, I wish this was GTA because I get out and have some stern words with you, mate. But okay. Anyway, going back along, we're going to a house called Sunflower Meadows. So, okay. Well, two things. Well, my jokes are insanely bad. Number two has just been a four-car collision. Mate, you're moving, I am. You don't love us. There we go. Right. That's like shenanigan. Back on the road. My brakes. I need more brakes in this thing. But anyway. Let's go. So, this will probably be the last delivery of the day. And then, we will be... We are really, really squabbly today. So, let's go. Get some speed. Let's go. Transit van in the middle of two lanes. Normal. Let's go. Come on. We've only got three gear, but let's come on. How fast can we get? Come on. Slow down a bit. Okay. Oh. As I was saying, I do 100% need better brakes because this does not work. Just notice the rear fenders that I put on the car look a bit like what you put on a fire engine. Anyway, we're going to be okay. I don't know what's happening with me. I can't drive though. Anyway, let's go through here. Going through town, me, up the way. Okay, we're fine, we're not fine, we're really not fine. We're fine. Why is it not on the full lock? So, our first delivery, if you can sit over there. The lighthouse, that is our first delivery. The house next to it is called Sunflower Meadows, and that's the house we are delivering to. And that is probably where we shall end the video. Here we are. The lighthouse, where it's complete day, but probably the reason. Yeah, here it is, ruined a caravan, I was advised. Didn't mind the gate. Apparently, we never opened this, apparently, it's completely jammed. They said. If you've got a car that doesn't get damaged, then please walk through it. Okay, so that is where I will leave it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. And next episode, we will probably have a brand new car. Now, our little surprise, but I'll just say now, it's got a V8, and it's pretty cool, and it's got dual wheels. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully, I'll see you next time. 6 years later. Goodbye.